Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. We're now going to talk about a different aspect of the SN2 reaction. It's the impact of the SN2 reaction on stereochemistry. Now, when you do an SN2 reaction, people will say that the stereochemistry is inverted. So we'll do two examples. First example is this iodide. This carbon has four different substituents. It is a stereocenter. So when this undergoes a reaction, what happens is, remember, this is a one-step reaction. All bonds form and break in the same step. So our nucleophile attacks at that carbon. And when it attacks, it actually attacks from the backside of this carbon iodine bond. And it attacks from the backside because it will eject this iodide. So both those arrows occur at the same time. People call this backside attack or attack from the back face of your electrophilic carbon. So azides are nucleophile. It attacks this carbon and we break that carbon iodine bond at the same time. Well, what happens is it changes the stereochemistry. So I'm going to draw the butyl chain in exactly the same way, but since the azide had to come in from the opposite face, in this case the back face, then that means the azide will now have the hashed position. It's below the plane of the writing surface. The hydrogen has now been pushed forward to the top, and the iodide is gone. If you want to keep track of it, there's sodium iodide. And so you can see our nucleophile is now on the back face where the leaving group was on the top face. So we get inversion of stereochemistry, and this always occurs in an SN2 reaction. Here's another example below it. Cyanide is one of our fantastic nucleophiles. It's going to attack. In this case, it's going to attack from the top face because our leaving group is on the bottom face. It's hashed. So as that nucleophile attacks, we break that carbon-bromine bond. Our leaving group leaves. And now when we redraw this, we will draw this top stereocenter with the cyano group being on the top face, and the hydrogen has been pushed down to be hashed. Now, what happens to this stereocenter? The answer is nothing happens to that stereocenter. It's not part of the mechanism. It is unchanged. So we just draw this in exactly the same way. This is a really common, I won't call it a trick question, but a question that's testing you is to see if you recognize the fact that the SN2 inverts the stereocenter where the chemistry occurs, but leaves the other stereocenters alone. Now, of course, this stereochemical inversion is only relevant if we have stereocenters. So if I drew this, let's say we had ethyl bromide, and I did an SN2 reaction on this, even though I've drawn this carbon as if it's a stereocenter, that's not a stereocenter. There are two hydrogens on that carbon. It is not a stereocenter. So there's, even though I'm trying to make it look like there's stereochemistry, there's not stereochemistry. So when the SN2 happens, there is no inversion because there's no stereocenter. So this only applies to stereocenters, but when you have a stereocenter and do an SN2 reaction on it, you will get inversion of that stereocenter.